Salvation. the strength of my body. For whom shall I be afraid? The righteous live forever. And the curse of them is with the Most High. With his right hand, he shall cover them. And with his arm, he shall shield them. But we know if our earthly house, but this tabernacle where it is all, we have a building. For God and house not made with man, eternal in the heaven. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth passed away.
Amen.
scripture, reading the Old Testament, Reverend Herbert Harlan, pastor of the chapel, CME Church, Mile, Tennessee. Then the New Testament, reading the Reverend James Dow Singer, pastor of Farmer Chapel, CME Church, Brown, Tennessee. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, our God.
Yes, yes.
We come this afternoon to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And much obliged for all that thou hast done for us. Mm-hmm. You've been so good to us.
Yes. Yes.
The old church has said you've been better to us. Mm-hmm. That we've been to ourselves,
yeah,
and to one another. Yeah. Lord, here we are today for a time of celebration, to celebrate the life and legacy of Pandora Flynn.
Yeah, yeah, Lord.
We thank you, Lord,
yeah, Lord,
for giving her to us. Given her to this family all of these many years. You've given her to be in their presence, in and out, time and time again. And so, Lord, we've come here today as family, as friends, and as the church to say thank you, Pandora. For you served well, you've done what you were called to do as a stewardess in the Christian Methodist Episcopal Church. We come to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For we do realize that you were born on Thanksgiving Day. And so, Lord, we come to say thank you.
Thank you,
Lord. For the many times you come in and out and prepare the Lord's table for first Sunday morning. We come to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
For traveling with the pastor as they go from house to house to visit the sick and shut in. We come to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
But I know this family is shouting and saying, thank you, Grandma. Thank you, Mama, for all that you've done for us.
Yeah.
And so, Lord, we are here. We say, weeping may endure for a night, and it's all right to weep. But we know joy comes in the morning, because you understand that joy. You know all about that joy. You know what it takes to come through some storm, to come through many dangers, toils, and snares. You know, because I've heard you say it to me. And so, Lord, we come to say thank you for giving your life to us. Now, Lord, come with all of thy quickening power. Kindle the flame of sacred love and touch our hearts today. Help this family, because after today, we want them to be able to move on and remember that you taught them about a Savior. You taught them about a Savior who can sit high and look low. You taught them about a Savior who's a healer, who's a comforter, who's a provider. You taught them about somebody named Jesus. And so we come here today, Lord, be with them after today. Be with this church, Phillips Chapel, after today. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, bless all of us that we do what we're supposed to do, and we'll see you after a while. When the morning comes, some glad morning, when this life is over, we'll fly away. God, give us some wings to join Pandora Flynn. Where the walls are made of jasper, the streets are paved in gold. Give us that when we'll be able to see her again.
Yeah, yeah.
In glory land. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Bless the service. Bless the celebration. In the name of Jesus. This is our prayer, Lord. This is our petition. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Since we believe that Jesus died and was raised to life again, we also believe that when Jesus returns, God will bring with him the believers who died. We tell you this directly from the Lord. He who are still living when the Lord returns will not be him ahead of those who have died. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with the commanding shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. First, the believers who have died will rise from the grave. Then together with them, we who are still alive and remain on the earth will be caught up in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Then we will be with the Lord forever. Word of God, who is people, thanks be to God.
God for blessing us to be here on this bittersweet celebratory occasion. Mother Blake was like a mother to me in this miniature, and she always had encouraging words to say. She always, when she saw me down, she lifted me up. And I thank you, praise God, for her. She honored me by asking me to sing her husband's home. And the family honored me by being able to sing at her. family asked me for this song that I sung for her husband, Bishop. And I thank God, Lord, for her on today. I thank you to testify to who she was as a child of God. I had some good days. And I've had some hills to climb.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yes.
I've had some weary days. And some sleepless nights.
Yes, yes.
But when I thank you.
Yeah. are also appreciative to staff and TPL Hospice who made our journey so much easier. Hartsdale thanks also Lois Jackson Clinic and Anthony Healthcare and Rehabilitation, Core Heart Clinical Clinic, Dynamic Spirit Therapy, Mount Pleasant Senior Church, Morris Chapel Senior Church. Most of all, thank you for the love for the chapel. Resolution. October 10, 2024. Dear Mrs. Cunningham, greetings to you in the beloved and comfort name of Jesus Christ. Jesus the Christ. I am sorry for your loss. It is my prayer that God will continue to give you grace and strength to you and your family. The first Episcopal district, thank God for the gift of your mother, Mrs. Carol Clay, to the life and witness of Philip Chapel Church. We are praying for you and your family. This is from Martin Frank Thomas, Sr., presiding prelate. CME Church, Mother Carol Clay. The College of Bishops, Christian Methodist Episcopal Church. Resolution honoring the life of Mother Pandora Swain, beloved student of the Church and mother of Lady Fellows Cunningham. As we come together in love and remembrance to the honor and honor of Mother Pandora Swain, a cherished student of the Trinity Church, whose presence and devotion have left an everlasting impact on our congregation and community. Her steadfast commitment to her faith and her role as a nursing mother guiding life to so many will forever remain in our hearts. Whereas Mother Pandora Clay faithfully served the Trinity Church with unwavering dedication as a student, she exemplified the virtues of humility, grace, and service. Her love for God was evident in every action, and her work reflected the essence of the Christian discipleship that she entirely gave of her time and talent. Whereas Mother Pandora was not only a faithful servant of the church, but also a loving mother of Lady Clarice Cunningham. Her nurturing spirit, wisdom, and unconditional love shaped not only the life of her daughter, but also many individuals she encountered through her journey. Mother Pandora's influence felt in the community and beyond as she radiated warmth, kindness, and compassion in all that she did. Whereas her legacy of faith, love, and service continues to inspire all those who have the privilege of knowing her, Mother Pandora is one of great strength and resilience, and her unwavering trust in God served as an example to all. Through her leadership as a student, she touched countless lives, always seeking to uplift, encourage, and guide others in their walk with Christ. Whereas her life one of dignity, honor, grounded in a deep commitment to her family, her church, and her community. Mother Pandora is a pillar of strength and a source of comfort for many, constantly illustrating the love of Christ through her actions. Her legacy lives on through the lives she touched and the examples she set. Therefore, be it resolved as we remember the esteemed church family and community, celebrate Mother Pandora's life today. We honor her faithful service, loving heart, unwavering dedication to the Lord. Though we will miss her presence, we rejoice in knowing that she received her heavenly reward, resting in the throne of the Savior she faithfully served. Be it further resolved, we extend our deepest sympathies and prayers to Lady Clarice Cunningham and her family on these loss. May the God of all memories of the love of her be servant of God. Finally, we commit to carrying forward the legacy of faith, love, Lifetime Christian Senior Church in Winston, Salem, North Carolina. St. Paul Senior Church, Jackson. The next person on the program is Sister Bobby Dunnell. For those of you who don't know me, because there are people who don't know me, but she, it's a few things we can't control. Sickness, death is one of them. So her husband wasn't doing well. She called me and asked me to do this, and I couldn't say no. So now I am speaking in the absence of Bobby Dunnell, who is president of this church, these are her words. These are mine. So y'all be sure to tell her. Y'all need to get the best. All right.
Amen.
Mrs. Pandora has been faithful. And that is faithful in all capacities. She loves students of the Church for many, many, many. And I can go on. 91 left. As long as I know Mrs. Pandora, she has been faithful.
Yes.
She served until she no longer could attend church. You notice I didn't say until her health started failing. She served until she couldn't come to church. The other two students, they're not 91, but they're, you know, getting on up there. And they would say, "You just sit." She said, "No, y'all don't understand her." No, I can't, you know. She was dedicated. She knew where her strength was coming from. So she did. She, I didn't say to her, that was her desire to serve until she could come to church. And God granted her that choice. She loved and turned the table for the community. Miss Pandora is the last, I do mean the last, of our church mothers. Her legacy will live on other mothers that have gone on before her. And there are many teachers, which we so from time to time, Mark, you know, we talk about. Because church mothers, we don't have too many of those today. But Miss Pandora, yeah, I'm 70, and she, you know, she's still 70, she needs to tell me something today. She say, "Yes, ma'am, keep going." All right, I'm going to leave you on this note. Everybody is familiar with LeBron James. I'm glad we're in this city, so that way we don't have to figure like Jordan James. y'all can't say nothing back to me, right? You're not going to get me right. LeBron James has been called the GOAT. He has nothing on Miss Pandora, okay? Because Miss Pandora is the GOAT of students.
Children. And she would tell her kids, "Now, you know this is your sibling now, okay?" a young age as a steward. She was my teacher. She was there for me. She would tell me, hey, you can do this. Don't ever give up. When I feel like I'm not making no progress, I call. She'll give me a couple scriptures from the Bible. She said, you go meditate on that, and everything will be all right. And also, I love Mama Pandora. I had a chance to spend and work with her, not only being a high school student with her children, but I got a chance to be with her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. I got to help raise them, see them grow up, see them become, you know, really inspiration, young ladies and young men. Families, y'all keep it going. Because I love you, the more siblings love you, and we're going to still be there for you no matter what.
Amen.
Shake it.
up for her and for us.
Man, I appreciate you.
That shows the love she had, that she gave out to everybody. Not only the family, but in the community. She was good at this community somehow. Don't nobody know, but you know, she had a lot of people in the community. I don't care what nobody knew about it. I say that what I've been going out this past week, I've met so many different people. And I didn't know mama knew. They said that for your mom. Well, she was this, she was that, she was so good. She said the sweet, she was loving, sweetheart, parent, person. And it's coming up, it's time for us. We live in Freedom House, Carmel Street, Bryant Street, and Jackson Street last month. And I remember when back in the day, and she used to work, take care of, you know, all the kids. I would say white kids, y'all, when we used to babysit all the maids back in the day. We used to go out one day. But those kids that she took care of, they loved her to death. We played with them, you know. And then people go around talking about prejudice, 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 like that. And my mom told us, don't be prejudiced, love everybody. There's no white, there's no black. He said, God's children, all of us were. So come up. And we had more sisters and brothers than we ever knew of. You know, like Ms. Dirks, you know, Jolena said she had to be her mom. There were, you know, it's a lot of them that kids went to school with, they called her mom. So, you know, she had different names, you know, some of them broke there like mom, mother, granny, mom, pan, grandma, Miss Pandora, Miss Flay, Sister Flay, Sister Pandora, all different names she had, it's coming from different people. Now, if I could, I got to attend it with me, because Clarice told me to write down something, you know, get something. This tablet, it will not fill up all what was in her heart and what was in her soul. I mean, for us and everybody else, you know. And I go back and say, the kids came over to the house and they played with us. Mom took them under her wing and she played with them just like everybody else. She told them differently, the kids of the community. The world in Carmel Street, Bryant Street, Jackson Street. So they come over to the house, they all play, she get in there, we play in Spain, and she get trying to play, bless her soul. And dad would be there with us too. Him and mom get together, they play with us. Dad will cut a card, pump card, boom! She's looking for you. Brenda, what you did? But you see that? You know, that's the way she was. But she's open heart, she's open mind, she's cad, you know. And that's like everybody else in the world. She got faults just like everybody else. Nobody's perfect. Don't look about perfect, Jesus Christ himself, Son of God. And I was perfect, she wasn't perfect, she had a faults just like everybody else would. She took the pain of what she did. She loved what she did. She loved this church. She loved the community. And when we do something wrong, you know, she died back. Especially when she was working hard. We at home and everything. What y'all do that? We didn't get y'all need something. So I was like, how you know? This little bird told me. Little bird told me. You never be mad at the bird. They got almost that bird down in the hood, not that bird rock somewhere, we don't know what we tell it. But we now find out what that little bird was. But that's what she was. She had, but we knew a lot of people watching us, so, you know, but she went to work and everything. She got there, she got the food, she did too. You know, in the opposite track, mom and dad, something like two different people. I said, be a group, but even I call him, you know, all this music and all that. But we didn't know no better being. But when dad did join church, he asked mama, can I go to church? She jumped some scripts, how she shouted. That's one of the best things in life. He came in here, he won the best meal of this church we ever had. He never stopped ever doing what she was doing, all the way his school, you know. He never stopped going to church when she was going out. He made sure she had the money to go all over the next couple of United States to bring up. And she's like, they're going to town, I'm going to town, she went to Las Vegas out there. And, conference out there, she went out there. Mommy, do the gambling out there. You didn't know how to practice it. I dropped the quarter machine. I got 2 quarters back in my pocket. Said, dang it, my money. So, that's the book, you know. But everything's so well. And the one other thing, too, y'all don't know, but we know, we might have. But she had 2 hugs, okay? She had 2 hugs. Now, if you have 2 hugs, don't be mad. Yeah, my dad James, he paid the bill. He said that. after Labor Day, she took a little quick. She rested the same house. She didn't make a field on my spit. Now, y'all ain't booted the other hood. You that problem say, phone the hall, up telephone. That's a sack of hood, right? She had that long lip talking on the phone.
Thank you. that the Savior has come. Be not dismayed when men don't believe you, and you'll understand that Savior will come. Oh, will I come to be
for the sake of time, I will not read the parable because I know you are very familiar with it. But I call your attention to verse 20. And it says this. So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents. Saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents. mm-hmm. beside them. Mm-hmm. His Lord said to him, well done, mm-hmm. good and faithful servant.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
You were faithful over a few things.
Mm-hmm.
I will make you ruler over many. Mm-hmm. Enter into the joy of your Lord.
Mm-hmm.
From that particular verse and its surrounding context, I lift the subject, well done.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Right. Right.
The evangelist Nick Bolton asserted, the pinnacle of the fulfillment I can ever experience for my spirit and soul is to hear from the Lord when I see him face to face. Well done,
yes,
my good and faithful servant.
Yes, yes.
Today, we gather to celebrate the life of Sister Pandora Blake. And give her the subordinate well done.
Uh-huh.
The superior well done she received on October the 1st of 2024
right.
from the one who created the universe.
Right.
In the text, Jesus tells the parable of a faithful servant.
Mm-hmm.
A servant applauds with the words, well done,
mm-hmm.
good and faithful servant.
Yeah.
The essence of a life lived with purpose, dedication, and service to God and others is summarized in these words.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
You see, brothers and sisters, Sister Blake lived and exhibited this kind of life. She utilized her God-given gifts to enhance and make a difference, as did the servant in the parable, who multiplied his talents. So did Sister Quick.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, you ask, how did she utilize her gifts in order to make a difference? She did it by being committed to the Lord.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Sister Blake, she showed us what it's like to be committed to God
mm-hmm.
by integrating her faith into every aspect of her life,
mm-hmm.
including her thoughts,
yeah.
actions,
all right.
and decisions.
Yeah. Yeah.
By consistently praying, and listen, let me tell you, let me throw this in. In her latter days,
mm-hmm.
I would go to visit Sister Blake,
mm-hmm.
and I would actually go to have prayer with her.
Right.
But listen, to my amazement, I went to pray in spite of her sickness and weakness. She prayed for me. I prayed with the intent of helping her to feel better and to feel stronger.
Yeah.
But I was the one that felt better, feeling better.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. She integrated her faith into all things, not only being consistent in prayer, but in studying the scriptures.
Mm-hmm.
She would often speak to me of certain passages and we dialogued about it.
Mm-hmm. I know.
She did the same by serving others and living according to her religious teaching.
Mm-hmm.
Sister Blake, she walked the walk and she talked the talk.
Mm-hmm.
If you wanted an example of a Christian, all you had to do was look at Sister Blake.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And you had your challenge.
Yeah, right. I know.
Listen, even when life was challenging, Sister Blake demonstrated a deep trust and reliance on God's guidance in all situations.
Uh-huh.
There was a number of times that Sister Blake came to me when she was in certain situations and experiencing certain things. But she would say to me, but Pastor, a Reverend, I know the Lord got me.
Yeah.
Listen, can't you hear Sister Blake? When those situations hit her, because she had intertwined everything into her faith journey, she would just sit back in those difficult times and just, I imagine, started singing, guide me, oh thou great Jehovah, help me through this very thing.
Yeah.
I am weak, but thou art mighty.
Yeah.
Hold me with thy powerful hand.
Yeah.
Bread of heaven,
yes.
Feed me until I walk no more.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sister Flame essentially put God first in her life above all else.
Yes.
When things were going on in the community and there was something happening in the church, she chose Philip Chapel Christian Methodist Episcopal Church to come to rather than the social. Sister Blake, she utilized her gifts, her God-given gifts, to enhance and make a difference, as did the servant in the parable who multiplied his talents by being devoted to her family.
Amen.
Listen, if I ever experienced someone that was committed to her family, it was just a thing. Every time you saw her, she had something good to say about her family. And I was always amazed how you all would get together and have lunch, and whether it was at home, or whether it was at Rapidly, or whether it was at Hig, or whether it was at Perkins. She got her kids together, those that were available, and she sat and she dined with them and enjoyed every moment. Because she knew there is a certain particular bonding when people sit down and break bread together. When we sit and eat together, it's more to it than just eating.
Amen.
I feel that God is in the midst.
Amen.
God is doing something to bring spirits together and help people to understand it better. And Sister Plank understood it. And I believe that's why she always looked for the opportunity to sit and dine with her family. Sister Blake, she encouraged her family and she made a difference with them showing devotion by listening to her family members when they had concerns and offering support and offering emotional support. Listen, Sister Blake, she would always share with me that she had sat down with the children of, the grandchildren of some of them, and had a conversation that something were on their mind. Man. And God had given her something to pour out to them.
Yeah,
and she said, Reverend, you know, I believe they felt better after we talked. Listen, you couldn't be in the presence of a Pandora's plate and prayed up and she stayed and talked with her and not leave feeling better.
Amen.
Amen.
Sister Blake, she enjoyed her devotion to her family in the form of celebrating achievements and special occasions with her family. I will always remember the last time I saw her. And this came to mind as I thought about special occasion. Well, this was when the last time I got to carry communion to her. On the first Sunday in July. She was in the rehab, so I went out to give communion to her. And Brother Carl and some of the family members were there, and a bishop, you know, I looked at Sister Blake, I consecrated the elements and everything, and she was laying there kind of weak and out of it. So it's my style to always get a cloth or something and put under it and give the bread and the juice myself. But as I took the bread and I began to put it to Sister Blake's mouth, she turned and looked me straight in the face and said, are your hands clean? and making them feel better. Well, Sister Blake utilized her God-given gifts to enhance and make a difference, as did the servant in the parable which multiplied his talent. She did it by attending important family events like graduations, birthdays, and weddings. Listen, grandkids, when Sister Blake attended your graduation, she had already gotten a taste of heaven. And her tests were poked out, and she would come back and bring her back safely. And then, Sister Britt, when she attended your wedding,
turn right on Kate Square.
She celebrated.
Then turn left
she
on
had a ball.
Street.
She got back to church, and she said to me,
turn right on Kate Square.
Pastor,
then turn left on Harris.
Do you know? No, she asked me. Did you see me on Facebook?
She told your son.
No, ma'am. Well, she said, and Bridget women, I couldn't run. And I said, Sister Blake, I have to go over there and see. And boy, I looked and she had her red on and she was couldn't run. So listen, this is the lesson that we learned from that moment. Because we hate, because we get it over, we don't have to lay down and give up.
That's right.
She taught us that as we age, we can have just as much fun then as when we were young. It's all in the heart and in the mind. Yeah, Sister Blake, she prioritized her family time over social events when necessary. And then she was a positive role model to younger members in the family. I mean, as she showed you love, as she was there for you on every occasion,
amen.
She was giving you something that to transform your life and that you can live on and that you can go through life selling and sailing with joy, happiness, and peace, and love, and have a successful life.
Mm-hmm.
Well, family,
well,
I talked about how you took care of us. But today, I want to salute you because you did a job par excellence in taking care of your mother, grandmother, and aunt. You did an excellent job, a super job. So therefore, I applaud. Well, as I draw to a close, I want to share with you how she made a difference with her God-given talents, with her loyalty to the church. Listen. She was loyal to the church. She was loyal to the convention of church.
Yeah.
She was loyal to the annual conference. She was loyal to the district. She was loyal to the local church. She showed her loyalty by carrying out the student's duties, exemplary, being dependable. I don't care where the meeting was, she was there.
I know.
Listen, almost every convention of meeting I went to, I knew shortly after I stepped through the door, I was going to see Sister Pandora Clay.
Yeah.
And if I didn't see her immediately, listen, when the student stepped out, she was going to step out proud with a smile on her face.
Yeah.
She loved the duties of a student. And she executed her student's responsibilities with the highest level of sophistication. As it relates to the connection of church, we learn a lesson from her that no distance is too far to love and appreciate and to show love for your church. Listen, and oh, when the duty was performed at Phillips Chapel Christian Methodist Episcopal Church, you could see the joy in her eyes, you could feel the joy in her heart. And then her persona, because her persona was saying every first Sunday at Philip, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away.
Yeah.
Listen, often, Sister Blake would come to the pastor's study on Sunday morning. Why? She wanted to make sure that her pastor was doing okay and feeling fine. And also, she wanted me to know that, Pastor, I'm ready to execute my duties as a steward. I'm ready to do it properly, and I'm ready to do it with sophistication. And I tell you, when she stepped through the door of the pastor's study, her uniform was crisp. I believe she could take it off, stand up, and it was and to carry out her responsibilities in executing Holy Communion, you could see Sister Blake look like she was going to go through the sky with joy in her face and joy in her heart. And I believe that she loved the church, the connection to the church, because she understood, I have a choice to keep, and I have a God to glorify.
Yes.
He gave his son my soul to save.
Yes.
And admitted for the sky.
Yes.
Well, Sister Blake, listen, well done. You've done an excellent job. You've done a great job.
Yes.
Well, now we rejoice that you have joined the saints who once went sovereign here, but now.
Yes.
And mingle
you and give you